Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Slim, aka Mr. Different. We are back with the part two of Mastering Your Beats. Now, today, the last time I talked about, you know, getting your levels right with a check for and dynamic range and what was mastering. Just a little overview of what to keep in mind when, you know, doing mastering and, you know, when you get to the mastering process. But now we're going to talk about a few things to do while mastering. Now, one of them is going to be mixed bus compression. Now, it's not really a big thing. I think it's one of the things that a lot of people do. I like doing using mixed bus compression because it kind of glues everything together. It's called mixed bus glue, mixed bus compression, master compression, whatever you want to call it. It's just a way of compressing the whole mix entirely, but just gently to where you kind of take everything, kind of bring everything closer together and more cohesive in the end. So I'm gonna show you a few plugins that you can use to do that, but technically you can do this with any compressor. Doesn't matter what compressor you're using. You can use FL Studio compressor, the limiter. You can use the Waves, I think it's the SSL bus or SSL comp. You can use the Native Instruments solid bus compressor. You can use the Slate Digital one. I mean, it's UAD. This goes on. No. Now I'm gonna show you what a bus compressor usually looks like when they make a specific bus compressor type of plugin, but I'm gonna be using a regular compressor because it's just because most people have regular compressors. So this would be like a bus compressor style, or you know, master bus compressor style compressor. Now, why did they use these? Back in time, they realized that they used to have these back in like the old console. They have like a compressor like on the master channel, and it was just a thing that sounded so good, you know, compressing everything through, like taking all the channels and summing them into that two bus and then compressing it. It just sounded so good that it just became a thing where mixed bus compression was, you know, the thing. And then, like I said, master engineers already do compression. They already put compression and stuff like that, multi-band, regular compression. But it's just nice to have, you know, that kind of compression already. So they started making compressors like this, and then more consoles started getting it. And then, yeah, now we got all kind of crazy stuff like this. So, yeah, so basically a master compressor is it's different from most compressors. Like, this one's kind of notched, so you don't have, like, individual, like, frequencies. You have, like, set frequencies and set, like, ratios and stuff like that. I like that kind of feel, so you have, like, limited choices. So basically it has the same thing. You mess with your attack. Your attack release, your ratio, your threshold, and your mega gain. So pretty much any compressor. And they do have these kind of cool VUs and stuff like that. But that's not the point. How you would set a master bus compressor or a mixed bus compressor, whatever you want to call it. You will have, usually they'll have like a slow attack. So they have like the slowest attack, the fastest release, a gentle ratio, probably about 2-1 up to 4-1. You can definitely go high if you want to. And usually you would try to get around, I would say, 2-3 dB at the most, like, you know, unless you're doing like rock and roll and heavy metal, you try to want to go like 4 and up, you know, to get that really metal squash sound and kind of aggressive sound. But you really want to be careful. Like I said, this is mastering. We're not trying to over compress it. We're just trying to glue everything together and give like a little glue. So that's how you would set it that way. But I'm gonna use a regular compressor because, like I said, most of you guys probably only own a regular compressor, so there's no point in me using like a kind of specialty compressor now. So I'm gonna use the Pro LC2 because it's basically a regular compressor, basic knobs. Only thing is it has a sidechain function, which I will be using. If you don't have this, I'll show you why it's good to find a plugin with one, why you want to use that. But if you don't own one that has a sidechain function, then don't worry about it. It's not gonna be a big deal, I promise you. But it does make a little bit of a difference. All right, so first, I'm going to go ahead and set my compressor. So I'm going to have like a, like I said, I'm going to have like a gentle ratio, probably about 2-1. I'm going to have the slowest attack and the fastest release. That's it. Right there. Boom, bam, boom, bam, bam. This one does have different type of modes, like mastering mode, whatever, and all that. But we ain't gonna worry about that. I'll probably leave it on that anyway. Well, not, why not? But yeah, no, don't worry about the styles. But that's basically what you want to do right there. Set your ratio, like I said, between 1-1, 2-1, 3-1. You know, if you're doing more aggressive style stuff, go a little higher. Don't try to go like over 5. You know, you just hyper compressing then. And you want to have, like I said, the slowest attack and the fastest release. And that's it. Then you're just going to bring in, you're just going to dial in some compression. So you can start dialing compression until you get that, you know, compressed sound. So let's go ahead and start compressing. So once again, I'm gonna start at the loudest part of my beat, and I'm gonna start bringing down threshold until I start getting some compression. And I'm gonna try to go for about, like I said, I'm trying to get gentle compression. I'm trying to get about 2 dB at the most, maybe 2.5, somewhere around there. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so I'm getting about 2 dB, 2.2, you know, it's all good. I'm gonna bring my makeup gain to match, because, you know, we're losing, if we're compressing stuff, we're losing gain, so we have to essentially bring it back. And let me change up my buffer so we can have, you know, more plugins on there. I just made a video about buffer size and latency, so yeah. So there we go. So we're gonna play the before and after real quick. So I'm gonna play you the before, and then I'm gonna bring it in. So let's hear it before. You just see how adding that little bit of compression, you are essentially getting a tighter, more conjunctural mix, and everything sounds like it fits together and it should be in the same zone, in the same area. So that's what it pretty much is. It's just kind of taking everything and gluing it together to make it sound like a single track. Like all them sounds that you had mixed together into that two track sound like they should be part of a two track. Now I'm going to show you if your effect, if your plugin has like a sidechain function, like a pretty much a sidechain EQ function in it. Basically what that does, it eliminates certain frequencies. Now, I don't want my bass frequencies to trigger my my compressor so hard. So I'm going to take out some of the bass frequencies of the compressor. So basically I'm telling the compressor to compress above a certain frequency. That way my bass is not always triggering it, because your bass, your 808s, your kick drum are going to trigger your compressor pretty hard, and you don't want to have it always compressing that hard. So I'm going to kind of take some of that out, and then, you know, that way I can, you know, still get that nice punch in the low end. I'm not losing the punch in the low end and making it muddy and over compressing it in the deck. I already have a bunch of distortion compression on my kicks and stuff like that. I want to preserve it. So let's go ahead and add that side chain in, and I'm gonna audition it, and I'm just gonna start eliminating some of the frequencies. I'm gonna turn it to about a 36 band. I'm gonna do kind of steep slope right here, and I'm gonna make it really surgical, make a surgical EQ, and I'm just gonna cut out some of them lows. So you'll hear me cutting out some of the lows here. You'll only hear the lows, but you know that's what I'm cutting out. So let's go to it. Now, because I cut out some of them lows, I'm gonna bring it down to about 120 or 125. Now that I cut out some of the lows, I need to boost my threshold back up to get back to that that compression I was getting, that 2 dB I was getting. So let's go ahead and do that. And all that's doing is preserving my 808. It makes sure that the kick drum and the low end is not constantly triggering that compressor, and it's taking them out of the compression pretty much. So when I do some other processing, I can still be able to push them a little further and get that good knock they're supposed to get. So, but if you don't have a sidechain function in your compressor, don't worry about it. It's cool. It's not going to be the end of the world. Just got to be careful how much you compress and process. So, yeah. That's mixed bus compression in a nutshell. Like I said, you can use any type of, you know, compressor. Don't really matter. Just remember, you want to have a gentle ratio. You want to have a slow attack, a fast release, and you just want to bring the threshold and get, like I said, 1-2 DB, maybe 3. You know, you don't want to go too heavy with it. Like I said, we're just gluing everything together and making it sound cohesive. So hopefully that helped. Hope you guys are using that mixed bus compression, you know, get that nice little sound going on there and make some hits. So with that being said, I'll see you guys in part number 2. Hope you guys enjoy. Y'all know who it is, your boy Slim, aka Miss Different. Not motivated by the money, but like, subscribe, and views. And I will see you guys next time. Have a good one.